Well, tonight is the night. I'm on my way to meet Rose's family. I'm so excited. I'm nervous, but mostly excited. This is all so new for me. You see, Rose is the first girl I've ever dated. I haven't been in a lot of relationships, but the ones I have been in have been with men. None of them were particularly bad, but I've never felt anything like I feel with Rose. We've only dated for 6 months, but we just clicked, and now she wants me to meet her family. You know, I've always been a little bi-curious, but growing up in my house, that wasn't even an option. See, after my parents died, I was raised by my grandmother. She's really conservative, and she didn't have any time for anyone's bullshit. She was not one to be trifled with. So after Big Mama took me in, I was raised in this really stuffy middle-class neighborhood. Big Mama and Grandpa were the first Black family to move into that neighborhood. She took so much pride in living there. It's like she had her own piece of civil rights history. She had clean homes and white people's homes to pay the mortgage and send me to college. Speaking of college, okay, so the question wasn't if I was going to college, but rather where I would go to college. Big Mama had created this short list of acceptable colleges. It was like my entire future had been planned out for me by the time I made it to middle school. I'd wanted to study art history in college, you know, maybe be a curator at a museum like the Smithsonian or something like that. I have a really good eye for art and design, but Big Mama wasn't having it. I had to carry myself in an acceptable way, respectable way, you know, acceptable to white people and also not to scare the white people. All of this meant choosing an acceptable major and having a respectable life. So art history and hooking up with girls was completely out of the picture. Respectability. So after my first semester at college, Big Mama decided to host this tea in my honor. She made a big deal out of it because I was the first one in my family to go to college, yada, yada, yada. So she invited all these people from junior league and these girls from my debutante season, essentially all the people that I could not stand. They're fake asses. Big Mom was always talking about how proud she was to be Black. And then she goes and hosts this pretentious tea with these pretentious members of pretentious Black society who were modeling the very rituals of white elitism that I thought we were against. What the hell? Plus, who's into tea at 18 years old? And she served it in these annoying little teacups with these little cucumber sandwiches, and all the people were there with their little raised pinkies. It was all too much. It was bullshit. So get this though. I walk into the tea with this massive afro, curls everywhere. I'm wearing my favorite bell-bottom suit from my favorite thrift store and this huge African medallion. It was wild. I looked like something from Superfly in the 70s. If you could have seen her face, all of their faces. She flipped. Big Mama completely flipped out. The next thing I knew, she had me sitting in her hairdresser's office with an appointment. My hair was fried, dyed, and laid to the side. It was cut into this awful, hideous bob. It was just so conservative. So not me. So I go back to college after winter break, and I had to decide on an acceptable major. Since I wasn't allowed to study art history, Big Mama and I came to a compromise, and I studied education. When I graduated, I started to make a decent living working with at-risk youth, but my dream was always art. After a while, I got restless, and I decided I needed to get away from home, so I moved to the city. I had saved up just enough money to start over and figure some things out. So now I live in the city. I ditched the bob and I work at a thrift store, or I shop at thrift stores again. They're a little bit more upscale now, but still it's not that designer crap. I work part-time in the most incredible place. It's called Cafe Ambrosia. It's right in the heart of the city. It's part cafe, part art gallery, part performance space, and just amazing. I've even performed with a band a couple of nights a week. It's really cool and I love it. Anyway, that's where I met Rose. At Cafe Ambrosia. I was working at a hostess as a hostess at the door when I first saw her, and she literally took my breath away. She's just so beautiful inside and out. At first, it was just kind of like a curiosity, you know, left over from college, mostly physical attraction. But it grew into so much faster. Now we live together. It just all happened so fast, like within 6 months. She's so confident and strong, you know. I get this feeling that she comes from a stuffy family too. I think they're old money, you know. But she's cool. She's not into that. None of that affects her. She really knows how to stand up for herself and what's right. After we met, we even went to this Black Lives Matter meeting together. She was so outspoken, so freaking dope. She's a real ally for the cause, you know? At that meeting, actually, that's when I started to fall for her. You know, even though her parents are old money, they're dope too. They're super liberal. No, for real, they're super liberal. They voted for Obama. In fact, her dad has said that he would have voted for Obama a third time if he could have. Can you believe that? That's so cool. Finally, cool, liberal white people. You know, we need more people in this world like the Armitages. Rose and I have been talking about traveling too. She knows how much I still love art, and so we're planning to visit Paris in the spring. I want to go to the Louvre, and she'll be there with me. Paris is such a romantic place. I mean, I've heard. It seems romantic. I've never been there. But it'll be nice to see it for the first time with Rose. Oh, shoot. Look at the time. Oh my gosh. Okay, so she's going to be here any moment and I'm running late. I was supposed to call Big Mama this week too. We haven't talked in so long. She was angry with me for throwing my life away, but I think she might have cooled down now. I need to call her. She's going to think that I died. Oh, deep breath. I'm so nervous. I mean, I've never gone home to meet anyone's family before. This is a really big deal for me. And to be honest, aside from the family stuff, if there's too many white people, sometimes I get a little nervous. But Rose is cool and her family seems so cool. I like her so much, it scares me. I've had this knot in my stomach all week, but I think it's just the nerves. Rose is really into me and into me for me. I think she loves me. I think she loves me for who I am. And I feel like she'd never try to change me. And I know this sounds crazy, but I might love her too. All I know is that for the first time, I get to be me. For the first time, I feel like I'm loved for me, just exactly who I am. For the first time, I feel free, like the rest of my life is just ahead of me. Rose, honey, what's going on? Come on, this isn't funny. No, I just want to go. This isn't funny, Rose. I just want to go home. This is freaking me out. No, I don't want to stay, and I don't want any damn tea. I want to go home, baby. Come on, let's just go home. Why are you calling me Georgina? Who is Georgina? You know my name is Syndey. My name is Syndey. Rose, call me Syndey. Oh my God, Rose, look at me. I just want to go home. I just want to go home. Can we just leave here? I'm really scared. No, my name is Syndey, Rose. My name is Syndey. Just call me Syndey. Just call me Syndey. Well, hello there. My name is Georgina. I'm the housekeeper here at the Armitage home. Welcome. Allow me to introduce you and welcome you into the home. I want to make you comfortable and at home and get you anything that you need because our home is, just think of it as your new home. Oh, you seem a little nervous. It's okay. Mrs. Armitage makes the best tea. Let me get you some tea. I love tea. It always makes me feel better. Tea makes everything so much better.